International, Pacific International Lines, PSA International, Tanzania Steel Pipes Limited, BS International Africa Limited, and Novembo and Sons for their gracious hospitality. With that, I wish you all a warm welcome to the inaugural Tanzania-Singapore Business Forum. It is now my pleasure to invite Mr. Teo Siong Sing, Vice Chairman of the Singapore Business Federation, to deliver the welcome remarks. Mr. Teo, please.
Thank you. Your Excellency, Jakaya Morisu Kikwete, President of the United Republic of Tanzania, Honorable Ministers and Ambassadors, distinguished speakers and guests, friends from Tanzania, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning. Karibu. On behalf of the Singapore Business Federation and members of the Singapore business community, it gives me great pleasure to welcome President Kikwete and his esteemed delegation of Tanzanian government officials and business leaders to Singapore. I would also like to extend my warm greetings to all participants here this morning. Your presence is a clear indication of the fast-growing interest in the Tanzanian market, and I hope that following this visit, our business level engagement will strengthen in time to come. Ranked fifth by the International Monetary Fund IMF, among the world's 10 fastest growing economies, Tanzania has an annual average GDP growth of 7% and is ranked one of Sub-Saharan Africa's top foreign direct investment FDI destination. As a leading East Africa FDI destination, Tanzania has pulled in an average of US $627 million FDI annually over the past few years. And between June 2011 to June 2012, attracted a record US $1.1 billion FDI. This indicates the growing confidence among foreign investors in Tanzania, East Africa's second largest economy. Its strategic geographical location on the shores of the Indian Ocean makes it a natural East Africa hub, with Dar es Salaam as the largest port of entry, serving its neighboring landlocked countries like Uganda, Rwanda, Burundi, Democratic Republic of Congo, Malawi and Zambia. This positions Tanzania as an entry point for business to a growing market of some 570 million consumers in East and Southern Africa. Tanzania is also endowed with a wide range of natural resources. Arable land is in abundance, with only 5% of these 44 million hectares currently under cultivation. Minerals such as gold, diamonds, tanzanite, ruby, iron, and coal, among others, are aplenty, with major discovery announced regularly. Likewise, natural gas discovery over the past few years is also transforming Tanzania into a natural gas hub and opening up a new frontier in oil and gas exploration in the East Africa region. The country is also home for world-famous tourist attraction, Kilimanjaro Mountain, Serengeti National Park, Ngorongoro craters, and the Zanzibar Island, among many others. All this spell much potential for Singapore companies, and I'm pleased to share that some of our companies are already doing business in Tanzania for a long time. We have Olam International, Wilma International, and Nomobo and Sun involved in agribusiness, Intra-Asia Capital in energy development, Comcraft Group in industrial sector, and Bond West Holding in hotel industry, PRL in the shipping and port logistics, among others. Many of these companies are here with us today and will share more with you on doing business in Tanzania in a panel discussion later on. Bilateral trade between Singapore and Tanzania stood at Singapore 126.5 million in 2012. And with South-South trade on the rise, we expect both countries to play an increasing important role in their respective region. The African Business Group was formed under the auspices of the Singapore Business Federation to facilitate exchanges between Singapore business community and their counterparts from the African region. This is done through partnership with business associations investment promotion agencies and private sector players, and comprises key Singapore business person and with interest in the African continent. The AFDG Secretariat team to date have engaged over 40 African countries and mounted missions to 32 countries on the continent. The SBF first visited Tanzania in 2011 in a visit led by Mr. Lee Ishan, our Senior of State Portrait Industry, with a delegation of over 30 members. This is telling of the great interest by Singapore companies in this market, and I'm pleased to share that I will be leading a delegation back to Tanzania in late August this year as a follow-up from His Excellency's visit and to further explore opportunities which our Tanzanian friend will be sharing with us today. I hope many of you will join this delegation in August. The Tanzanian shift from an agri-based to an industry and energy-based economy, opportunities for Singapore companies are abundant. Given our development expertise and complementary strength, in particular in ports, logistics, housing, infrastructure planning, oil and gas services, and hotel, there are many ways in which we can contribute to a mutually beneficial growth. The MOUs that will be signed today are a case in point, and I hope that the interaction between our business communities today will gradually translate into deeper engagement and subsequent collaboration. Thank you for being with us this morning. Asante sana. It's now my pleasure to invite His Excellency, President Kikwete, to deliver the keynote speech. Excellency, sir.
Thank you very much, Theo. Distinguished captains of industry and our ministers from Tanzania, the business communities of Singapore and Tanzania present. But I feel greatly honored and privileged to address the first ever Tanzania-Singapore Business Forum. I thank the organizers, the Singapore Business Federation and the Tanzanian Investment Center for conceiving the idea, this idea, and for the excellent arrangement. I hope this will be a new beginning for a more sustainable and innovative cooperation of the business communities of our two countries. I'm particularly pleased to see a number of Singapore business people gathered here. I'm told more than was actually expected. This demonstrates your enthusiasm and keen interest to do business and invest in Tanzania. All that I can say, Tanzania is ready to do business with you. My delegation and I are here to facilitate, to tell you about the country, and to tell you that we want to see more and more of you do business with us. As you may be aware, Tanzania and Singapore enjoy a very cordial relationship. At a political level, we see eye to eye on many global issues of interest. We support each other in international fora. But this time around, coming here to cement those political relations, my main mission is economic. As we'll see from my program, I have only one political engagement with the president. After that, the rest of the program is about engaging the Singaporean business community. Of course, as we say, our diplomatic and political relations are good. Economic relations remain low. I'm not saying it's non-existent, but the volume is very minimal. Your exports to Tanzania are more than $400 million. And the imports from Tanzania our 12 million. So you can see. But the potential is huge. We have not explored the potential of our two countries. In this regard, it is my mission here to improve the existing economic ties with Singapore and develop them to greater heights. We'd like to see Singapore buy more goods from Tanzania and Tanzania buy more goods from Singapore. We'd like to receive some potential investments from Singapore and so on. I'm not sure about the capacity of the Tanzanian business and women to invest in Singapore. For now, we want you to come. And if there are any who can also do something, fine. In my view, this joint business forum is a good forum for attaining this ambition. It affords us the opportunity to exchange ideas and explore ways of improving investments and trade.